Doing a quick review this week, it's Cosmic Ark for the Atari 2600. Well, let's open the YARG file on this game and see what it's about. Not much really to say about Cosmic Ark. It came out in 1982 for the 2600. And hey, there was a TV ad. Let's check it out.
TV! Check. Cosmic Ark cartridge. Check. Power!
Yeah, power!
Cosmic Ark is a game cartridge for the Atari video system.
Meteor! I got it!
The Cosmic Ark searches out strange creatures on distant planets.
Beam them up!
But the deeper the Ark travels in space, the tougher it gets.
Beam them up and get back to Earth!
Boy, I'm in your room.
We're back.
Cosmic Ark by Imagic. The video system must be bought separately and connected to the TV by your parents.
So yeah, let's check out the game. The first phase is the meteor storm, where you have to shoot oncoming meteors. And the second phase is going to the planet and collecting alien specimens. Basically, you just move your little shuttle on top of the aliens and run your tractor beam, and it sucks up the aliens into the shuttle. Then you get back to the mothership, and basically that's it. In later levels, the meteors get faster and faster, obviously. Also, on the planet's surface, once you get past the first level, you have to worry about the planetary defense system, which shoots lasers that kills your little shuttle like it just did. So, you have to get back to the ship before the alarms start sounding, because that means a meteor is coming to hit you. Like that one. If you didn't get all the specimens on the planet, once you get through the meteor shower stage, you're going back to the same planet to get the last specimen. So, yeah, ideally you'd like to get both specimens in one go. And as you advance, things on the planet get more difficult also. The aliens start moving faster, and the planetary defense system starts shooting more often. So, yeah, this game gets difficult fairly quickly. At higher levels, the meteor storm part becomes the ultimate in Atari 2600 Twitch gameplay. You've got one chance to hit those meteors as they come at you. According to the manual, the backstory of the game is the survivors from Atlantis have decided to go out into space in a giant ark and collect specimens of aliens for, I don't know, to repopulate a planet or something. Personally, I think that what's really going on is these aliens are running a restaurant and they need new menu items, and that's what they're looking for. Looking for things they can barbecue. That's the story I'm gonna go with, anyway. So yeah, I think you get the general idea of the gameplay of this. It's pretty standard, up, down, left, right for the meteor strike screen. And on this screen, basically, you use the button to pick up the dudes at the bottom of the screen. Yep, here's where the game starts to get difficult, and I'm gonna die fairly quickly. While I was researching this title, I thought it was interesting that the Starfield background you see was actually caused by a glitch in the 2600 hardware that the programmers took advantage of, and it seems to be a pretty good effect. Yeah, this game's starting to get outside my skill level, I think, so expect frequent deaths. Once you've run out of energy, that's it. Game over. A little escape pod goes off, but hey, I at least got over 10,000 points, so that's something. So yeah, this was a great game for the Atari 2600 with very little to complain about. You know, I would have liked some music or something, but not really required. Overall, I give this game an A. Hey everybody, thanks for watching my video. If there's a specific game you'd like me to review, drop me a note in the comment box below. If you liked the video, give me a thumbs up. If you didn't, give me a thumbs down. If you want to see more of my stuff, why not subscribe? Also, if you really want to, you can support me on Patreon. Thanks for watching.